Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection because perfection doesn't exist. Today I want to share some more budget versions of bestsellers and some luxury skincare we have today. Now these are all products I've tried, both the expensive and the budget version. I just want to share how I feel about both. So let's start with cleansing balms. Clinique's Take the Day Off cleansing balm is $29 and has been really, really popular. And I kind of get it, but also kind of don't. And I'll talk about it in a minute. But my budget version of this is gonna be the number 7 cleansing balm at $12.95. Both of these are 125 milliliters. Now, similarity wise, they both break down beautifully. Like, they're so nice to use, they're easy to use. You don't have to spend ages melting it down and rubbing it in. You aren't left with those little plasticky feeling bits on your hands that you have to put more effort into rubbing away. Both contain antioxidants and some nice oils. Those kind of ingredients aren't the be-all and end-all for me when it comes to cleansing balms in particular. They're nice to have because you can slowly massage over your skin and, you know, for a couple of minutes and not dry out your skin, get all that goodness from the ingredients in and rinse away. What I will say though, however, when it comes to the differences is that the number 7 cleansing balm actually feels a lot nicer than the Clinique cleansing balm. Honestly, the Clinique cleansing balm feels a lot cheaper than the number 7 cleansing balm. It has that plasticky, very traditional cleansing balm feel to it. The number 7 feels like a more richer, almost whipped cleansing balm. And to be honest, the Clinique one is very, very simple in the sense that it's a very typical cleansing balm with not too many bells and whistles. It will cleanse your face, it will break down into an oil, it will emulsify and rinse away. In the number 7 cleansing balm, we have the addition of more oils, almost like gentler and easier kind of cleansing experience, purely because of the slip of the product. We have soothing panthenol in here and so many more emollients just to make the product more enjoyable to use. To be honest, I'm not fussy when it comes to cleansing balms. So if there is a nice one that I can get for cheaper, I'm gonna use it. I've never used an expensive cleansing balm that I thought, wow, this feels luxurious, you know? SK2 Essence, an absolute icon. So the Essence is huge and you can get it anywhere from 95 to 110 pounds that I've seen online. And I love it. This for me feels, it brings back so many memories for me, and I'll be honest, is a product I do spend the money on, not because I think it's worth it, but I enjoy using it, and as I said, the smell brings back memories. But my budget version, my more affordable version, is the COSRX Galactomyces 95 Tone Balance Essence. Now, when it comes to things like dupes and more expensive things, I'm not just looking for similar ingredients at all. I don't think that's how you kind of like, you know, just because a product has the same ingredient list, it doesn't make it an exact dupe. What I'm looking for is the effects, key ingredients, but how it makes your skin look and feel. And this is the closest match I found to the after effects of an SK2 Essence. The brightness of the skin, the plumpness of the skin, the overall kind of like anti-aging effects of the key ingredient, which is Galactomyces Ferment Filtrate, which they both have in here. SK2 call their ones Patera, which is just a trademark name, but they both work the same. And Galactomyces Ferment Filtrate is, again, it's a brightening ingredient, it's an anti-aging ingredient, it's a firming ingredient. It does so much for the skin, and SK2 used to be on its own. Like, nothing came close to SK2, but brands now, a lot of brands contain that Galactomyces Ferment Filtrate in affordable ways. The COSRX has the extra benefit of feeling more hydrating on the skin, a lot more hydrating actually, and the added benefits of niacinamide to really, really boost that evening or skin tone and brightness of the complexion. We have hyaluronic acid in there as well as panthenol to soothe, and allantoin as well. It makes for an all-round nicer experience for your skin. You feel luxurious using SK2 because it's SK2 and you're like, oh, and so fancy. But the COSRX one just makes your skin look good, feel good, and in the long run, it brings amazing, amazing results. You can get the COSRX one for around £20, depending on where you buy it from. And honestly, it's so readily available and so worth the price and the purchase. I honestly think it's one of the best essences I've ever used. Okay, here's one. The Estee Lauder Advanced Night Repair Repair Synchronized Multi-Recovery Complex Serum. This is Estee Lauder's, like, trademark product, right? It's been viral for as long as it's been released. Everyone absolutely loves it. And it is a really, really good product. I used it. It's nice. It was very nice. I never reviewed it because, honestly, I do think it's expensive for what it is. So my budget version is going to be the ISNTREE TW Real Bifida Ampoule. So the Estee Lauder Serum is £86 for 50 milliliters, and the ISNTREE one is around the £20 mark for 50 milliliters as well. So the similarities here is these are probiotic-rich, humectant-rich serums. And that's really all this is, with the main selling point of both these serums, both containing that bifida ferment lysate, a probiotic thought to help with things like skin barrier repairing, potentially help with fine lines and wrinkles, with Estee Lauder saying it can repair DNA. I'll be honest, I'm not 100% sure what that means or why we need that, but sure. Obviously, these are both going to give your skin a really, really nice hydrated finish. So obviously these are both going to really hydrate your skin, both with sodium hyaluronate, we have glycerin, and I believe squalane is in there too in the Estee Lauder one, so nicely moisturizing without being greasy. We have caffeine in the Estee Lauder one as well, which is a nice antioxidant. So the Estee Lauder one does have those benefits, extra benefits, sorry, that the ISNTREE one doesn't. However, I do think the Estee Lauder one is nice because they're able to charge for that luxury price tag, the name, and the fact that it is a tried and true, tested, whatever the term is, tested product through so many years. But as I mentioned, essentially what the key ingredients do in here is to hydrate and that all-important bifida. Both have a fair few fermented ingredients, with ISNTREE's having niacinamide as well. The differences really are that the Estee Lauder one feels expensive. It's a nice, luxurious formulation. And the ISNTREE one feels like a basic serum, which is fine. They feel nice too. And as I mentioned, whilst I don't just compare products by their ingredients and call it a dupe, I'm going to do it here because that bifida ingredient that Estee Lauder is using to make their product sound so expensive and niche and luxe and sound worth the price tag, you can find in much more affordable skincare. I feel like I should have talked about this product more than I already have, but this is the Glow Recipe Ceramide Serum. That's £38 for 30 milliliters. A lovely serum. It's like milky, it's rich, it's ceramide-y without being clinical. It's so nice to use. However, I have a dupe, and that dupe is gonna be the Inkeyless Ceramide Treatment at $14.99 for 30 milliliters. So let's talk about similarities. Ceramides. It's ceramides, and that's kind of it. Whilst I will say that both have this nice creamy moisturizing feel to them, and both leave your skin feeling really nourished and even soothed, the ceramides are really what we're going for here, and both have a really nice amount of ceramides. You know, the different kinds of ceramides. I'm not all clued up on how different ceramides work and how much you need and if it needs to be a certain amount and all that kind of stuff. But they have the ceramides in. They have what we're using to help heal and soothe our skin. If your skin barrier is damaged, ceramides is what you need, is what you want for your skin. The difference is really is that you have more ceramides in the Glow Recipe one. Again, I don't know if that's a bonus really, or if some ceramides do, I don't even know. But we also have cholesterol, but I'm not sure that necessarily equals better. As in, I have no idea. What I will say is that the Glow Recipe Serum is soothing as hell. It's so nice. People are usually using ceramides when they have damaged, irritated skin. So the added bonus of the Glow Recipe one that soothes your skin, it's great to have it all in one serum, right? We have avocado, allantoin, turmeric, green tea, cucumber in here as well. More soothing ingredients, and we also have more hydrating and moisturizing ingredients as well. You are usually looking for ceramides, as I said, when your skin is damaged, and having those serums contain everything, all the different abilities, like the soothing, the ceramides, the repair, all-in-one serum works great because that means you can minimize your routine, which is often recommended when you have a damaged skin barrier. So you have your cleanser, this one serum, and then your moisturizer. So that Glow Recipe one will fit in perfectly in there. The Inkeyless one is still great, however, at repairing the skin. I used it all the time a couple of years ago. As CeraVe became more popular, I hated their formulations, and I found this ceramide one from Inkey List, and it blew me away compared to other ceramide products I used at the time. So this serum is still going to repair your skin, it's going to lessen irritation over time, and it's in such a nice lightweight yet moisturizing formulation. The Glow Recipe one I probably wouldn't use in the morning. This one, the Inkey List one, I would use morning and night because it's lightweight but still like moisturizing enough. Honestly, the Inkey List price tag isn't as affordable as a lot of their other products at $14.99. I would actually honestly just buy CeraVe's Hyaluronic Acid Serum that has all the above in it at £19, because you get a little bit more for your money. It's still a really nice serum, but with the CeraVe one, you do have your ceramides and you have that kind of like nice hydrating feel to the serum that kind of knocks out what I usually hate about CeraVe products, which is that clinical clunkiness of the product. Both still a bargain compared to Glow Recipe's £38 serum, but I will go to my deathbed loving Glow Recipe products. I love the formulations. You just do not get the luxury feel of the formulations with brands like Inkey List and CeraVe, and their products make your skin look and feel like it's worth the money. But you can find ceramides everywhere nowadays. There is absolutely no need to spend more than £20 on a good ceramide serum, moisturizer, anything with ceramides in, you can get at a bargain price pretty much everywhere. So there we go, short but sweet today. Those are some of the products that I know and love, but have very good affordable alternatives as well. Let me know if you've used any of these down below, or any of your dupes that you think I should check out in the comments down below. You can watch some more product reviews here, some general light entertainment here too, and I'll see you over there.